Good morning, Kelly. It's so nice to be back where I've spent most of my life. But the most interesting bit, I know Kathy and Mohit asked this question. I think a more appropriate question would be, who amongst you does not have a Gmail account? Oh my gosh. Okay, I'm done. Let's discuss something else. I think a couple of things that really matters to us. Innovation, that's the key. When I speak to CIOs and CXOs across Asia, that's really what matters. And you know, it all starts from us. If you really think about innovation within us, it's hitting us. I don't know how many of you read yesterday, Times of India had an article where a doctor in Delhi used Google Glasses to actually do a live transmission of an operation that he was doing to his students who were placed all over India. That's the power of innovation that's touching us. I have a teenager son. The way that he works, the way that he does his classes, the way that he learns, it's so radically different than what I did. That's why probably we have a couple of arguments every day, but that's the way that technology is hitting them. His entire school has all these things on Google Apps. He does not get any textbooks home. It is hitting us, guys. It's hitting us in a personal level. And if we do not take that step of making sure that we as when we are part of the enterprise, we're going to be late. Our competitors are going to take that walk and walk away right from under our eyes. If you really look back a few years back, we had to really go to our office to work on devices that we were given to collaborate with people, to make us productive. But that limited the very fact that we could only collaborate when we were in the office. And it could only happen with the people who were in the office at that point in time. But it's changing. This is what we saw. And these are photographs done right here outside. And you know the best part? It was done by one of my colleagues, whereas this deck was actually with that lady there, and she didn't need to do anything. This is running of Google Apps. All she did was just refreshed. This is innovation, guys. This is innovation that's happening. But now the office is actually anywhere at any time. You do not need to be in the office to be able to collaborate with people. It's about getting people, getting collaboration happening from anywhere and in any device that you want. Google Apps was designed specifically for this. It was designed not only to work on the device that you wanted it to, but to get the right content, to get people, and to get conversations right on that device so that you could be more effective, not as an individual, but as a team. We all know that today, in the competitive world that we live in, it's not about individual productivity. It's about team productivity. And to make that happen, collaboration is the key. Let's start with devices. Again, look 5 years back, and I think there's no better country than India today to really see the onslaught of the mobile. We had an average 5 years back of approximately 1.3 devices per user. He had that nice looking laptop lying on his table in the office. And some of them had BlackBerry. In today's time, it's almost three devices per individual. He has his laptop, he has his mobile, and he has that smart device too. And it gets more complicated because people now want to get that device to the office to actually access the applications that they want to use to be more productive. Jesus, rest. That's what CIO's nightmare is, right? How many of you are here from the IT part of their business? Does that really make sense? Is it really happening in your organizations? People are wanting to get those devices and say, you know what, don't give me a device, just give me access so that I can use it anytime, anywhere. And I want to be productive. To make it even more complicated, not only they want to get their own device to access those applications, they want to use all these three devices at the same time. If you really look, I'm sure most of you would have used Facebook at some point in time, if you aren't using it right now, but we use Facebook not only on our laptops, we use Facebook on our mobile, we use it on our smart devices. And we type in a message on the desktop and then we are walking and see another message from a friend and we use our mobile to actually reply back, right? We use it all at the same time. And it happens in the enterprise too. We start a document in the office. We're driving to some other meeting. We want to be able to access that particular document so that I can update it because my boss wants it by the end of the day. We reach our home, have a look at the document, and then send it out. It gets more interesting, I think. It's not only complicated, it gets more and more interesting. Today, in an enterprise, and I really had to find this to borrow, and thanks to Kathy. If you really wanted to do collaboration, you recognize this, right? You put documents on this device to actually share and collaborate. Or you send an email with an attachment, a versioning nightmare if you were to collaborate with five people, trust me. Or you put it on a file share drive in the office, but that means your users need to be in the office using the devices that you gave them to be able to link up so that they could work on that document. Gone are those days. We want the document to be there at a central place so that I can, on a click of a button, share it with the people that I want to collaborate in real time. When we prepare for events such as this, when I want to collaborate with my team members or Mohit or Kathy, we could be in any part of the world. Just last week, we actually had a collaboration with Kathy was in the US, Mohit was in India, Harshal was in Mumbai, and I was in Singapore to create this deck, to make sure that are we getting a message across to you guys. That's collaboration. That's the way it's happening today in the enterprise. That's why Google is known for its innovation. We don't have phones on our desktops. We just have our laptops. So it's not about moving your email servers to Google servers. It's about having the content that you want at a central location to be able to collaborate with the people you want so that you, as a team, are productive. You know, all these IT people who are here, they don't want to spend time in making sure that the light bulbs are on. They want to get that innovation. When you upgrade servers which are lying in your office or in your backyards or in your data centers, do you think it really makes a difference to the business? Are you upgrading to make a difference to the business? No. You are upgrading because it's probably the end of life for that. But when you are doing innovation, when you're using applications such as Google, it makes a difference because you are actually making an impact to the business because you're getting innovation. You're using collaboration to help your business. And guys, as I said, if you don't do it, somebody else will. Your competition will. You heard Mohit talk about applications that are from our suite. You heard about the developer platforms that we allow our customers, developers, to actually create applications, or our marketplace, which is available, where you can use applications that have made our customers highly successful. All this is built on the infrastructure today that we, over the last 15 years, have spent on making sure that your data is as safe, as secure, so that it's not only about security, it's about reliability, and it's about scalability. When you're using Google Apps, it runs on the same infrastructure that runs Google and Google.com. Didn't we at Google set the pace or set the limits, the boundaries of search today that happens on the internet? We expect Google to give us answers to whatever we want today in sub milliseconds. It's become so much natural as a part of us. Well, it's taken a lot of effort and time to make sure that that infrastructure is available. I don't know how many of you are aware, but YouTube happens to be the second most searched website after Google.com. And there are millions and millions of hours of YouTube video that's out there. 72 hours of videos gets uploaded every hour. Imagine the infrastructure today that we at Google have set up to make sure that this is highly possible, reliable, scalable, and yet secure. So what is Google Apps all about? I know all of you, none of you raised your hand when I said who don't, but if you really look from an enterprise perspective, it's about Gmail, which is our email. We spend a lot of time on our inbox. I don't know how many of you tried it, but if somebody asked me as a person, is an individual thing that I like about the inbox, it's your priority inbox. After a couple of days, my Gmail already knows who are the users that I usually read emails from, and it prioritizes that. I get to see, I get about 300 to 400 emails a day. Do you think I can read all of them? Certainly not. But it knows exactly that who are the users that I respond to, I read it, and it gives it to me as a separate thing. Try it out. Calendaring, your contacts, all that information is there, available right within your Google Apps. Google Drive is the place where it's the repository where you can have all your information either uploaded, if it's in a different format than what Google allows you to, or our docs. But the best part is, I can use Drive on my mobile when I'm offline. I can still get access to those documents from any device, from anywhere. All I need to do is install my Drive on my mobile or on my iPad. And then comes the world of Google Docs, where I can create my documents, share it, collaborate on it, and make it available. Again, from any device. I do not need to be on my desktop to be able to access this. We're using a Google presentation right now to actually showcase this to you. Do you think we use this to transfer it from wherever it was lying in one corner to the team there to actually get this up on the screen? No. On a click of a button, it was shared with them. Google Sites. It's so important for us in the enterprise world to be able to share information with our teams. to collaborate within teams, to have sites where I can get information out across to my employees. Do you know communication happens to be one of the most important things that an enterprise looks for? It's all possible to do today in Google Sites. And what best? They do not need to come to IT to help them create it. The business knows how to do this. The business knows what documents need to be shared within the team. And that's possible using Google Sites. Google Plus, all of us love the social world today. And this is our version of being social. It's not about an email ID. It's not just about a name. It's about a photograph. It's about a personality. It's about visual. What are my likes? What are my dislikes? That's what social is giving to. And if you really look at the newer applications that are out there, all of them add a touch of social to them. This is what we use day in, day out at Google. This is what the 5 million customers of Google are using. And Hangouts. We love to see a face. We love to have a face to a name. We love to associate with that. And that's what Hangout does to help more collaboration happen. And you'll see this magic very soon.
To help me show you the magic, I would like to introduce Harshal. So let's do something different, radically different. Let me take a hat of a customer, and we let Harshal be a Google sales engineer who's out here to help me prove if Google Apps can really help enterprises. Okay, Harshal, here's my problem. I come from an enterprise which has, you know, we have offices all across India, a few offices globally. Tell me really, how does communication really happen in Google Apps? Can you help me showcase this to the team here? I have a big team here, fortunately, so that they're going to be evaluating you. Help me understand, how does Google Apps help?
Sure. Communication actually is the core. And when people go to the office, they want to communicate. Any project that they do, any task that they do, they do not want to do it alone. There will be maker-checker, right? A new project or a tender. He's not working in isolation. So that is the core philosophy of Google Apps. So what I am going to talk about here is that itself being automated makes your life simpler. So I'm going to show a simple use case. And everyone uses Gmail, right? So I'm going to show a simple interface of Gmail and some of the things that we can correlate to what you're asking. So this is my, you know, regular inbox, which is your regular inbox as well. Start of the presentation, we talked about different types of inboxes and how it can simplify your settings. I go to settings, I go in inbox. You will see different types of inboxes. And it is nothing but the way the emails are served to you. So let me select priority inbox. And you can have more customization around it. I say save changes. So even if I get like 100 emails, 200 emails, over a period of time, this becomes more and more intelligent. And the frequently responded or the critical emails, the system understands and pushes you at the top. This is a bare minimum of an email. People use email in terms of doing translation as well within the email. The beauty of this interface for enterprise is this has been tested by billions of clicks. Your click, my click. So the product that you get for enterprise is with billions of clicks already. So it's not a beta product, which is one of the great things. Now, you talked about communication. So how we are going to communicate? Email is, of course, the lifeblood. And we provide 24/7 availability of it. This is a chat interface. Let me see if my colleague Pratish is here. Yeah. So you use anyway chat as well. Now I am going to get in a role where I am from a company called Apps Demo. I am interacting with a company, VitalSign, and they have a requirement of collaboration. They have a requirement for new innovation that is coming in. So I don't know where Pratish is. I am not going to use my phone. I'm going to use instant messaging and do some interaction with him. So I don't know where he is, but I'm chatting with him. I can have a group chat as well. I'm sure many of you must have used group chat. You can invoke a hangout, a video call there itself. Feel free to send an invite. Okay, great. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to invite him and have a discussion with him. Feel free to send an invite. Anybody else? So what I am demonstrating is the communication that you talked about can be used using the same console. You don't flip between different applications or different windows. Companies are saving huge amount of money on STD, ISD costs. If you are on a mobile, you use mobile to have this kind of communication. So this is just one way of communication that we talked about. Within the interface, there is something called as calendar. And when we came in here in the morning, there were some videos. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to invite few team members. So these are the guys that I would want to come in. I want to have a video call. Vital sign, sync up. What you can also offer is your rooms can also be tagged. So you block a room then and there itself. I'm going to do save. It sends an invite. I'm going to have a chat with them. I'm getting in a hangout. So I'm going to collaborate with them. I'm going to discuss with them that how it can be done. And the deadline is they want this to be done today itself in a couple of hours.
So while Harshal is getting into the hangout, you saw that the user does not really need to go to IT to actually configure the way that he wants to use his email solution. He configures it the way that he thinks he's going to be more productive. That's the power that you're giving it to the users to be able to help them take that reins of their productivity in their own hands. It's about that one window which Harshal is using actually to do his communication, to do his collaboration. He did not have to switch windows or go somewhere else, or even for the room booking, he didn't need to go. Resources, he gets it all there on the same platform.
And you don't need to get tied down to a specific video conferencing room. It can be from anywhere. It can be from mobile as well.
Yeah, I know somebody from your company was speaking about being anywhere, anytime, or any place. Interesting, makes it sounds good.
So let's start this hangout. Hi, Pratish.
Hey, Harshal, how are you?
I'm all well. You have to be a bit louder. I can't hear you properly. Hi, Shashank.
Hey, Harshal, how are you?
All well. Is Fifi also joining?
Hey, Fifi is not part of the invite. Harshal, can you add her?
Yeah.
She is not
yes,
part of the
I think I missed it. Yeah. Let me just add Fifi as well. Yeah, it's already sent.
Okay, cool.
So you want me to ping her as well? Invite Shashi, okay, great.
She's already in.
Great. Hey, so let's start. All of us are here.
Hi.
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 Fifi, you're in which city right now?
Yes. I'm connecting in from Sydney. Hi, everybody.
Hi.
Hi.
Let's say a big hi to Fifi.
Fifi, the reason why I have invited everyone is I met up with the CEO of VitalSign. You are anyway aware that we are interacting with them. So they have some specific requirements, and they want the tender response first cut to be shared today evening itself. And since you have worked on a similar kind of industry, you know, VitalSign, you know, topmost healthcare company, and you have worked on it, so I thought I'll check with you 3-4 people so that we can finish that document today. Is it possible?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely, Harshal. We can start a doc and then probably work together.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes.
Sure. So I will send you a doc. I have a, you know, base format. And my expectation, or rather customer expectation, is we finish it in next 2-3 hours before 5 p.m. I need to send an email to them.
Sure.
So, yeah. So I can actually start creating and sharing the document now itself, but you know, let's disconnect from here, and you will see an email from me which has a document, and we can start working on the document shortly. Is that okay? Yeah.
Okay.
So you can hang out. You know, you can disconnect. So that's great. Oh. Thanks everyone.
Thank you.
You see the difference in the way that you are communicating, collaborating. It's not about an individual anymore. It's about the team. It's about how this team can collaborate. And more than an email or a phone number or a name, it's about a face. It's about getting that feedback there and then. That's the power. We use this, and the 5 million customers across the world today use this to be able to communicate.
One interesting example that I want to cite, one of the seeds manufacturing company, agriculture company, they are using it. And what they are using, interestingly, is every district or tahsil where their sales guy goes, they invite the farmers to come there and they do hang out with the central office. So farmers get a huge attachment. Agricultural questions are sorted out then and there itself.
Awesome.
IT is sitting at one place. And there is a support call coming in, you can do remote desktop. And the other party will say, okay, I will allow the IT guy to see my desktop and take control of my desktop. It saves huge amount of money, huge amount of time. We talked about a document. I have this specific document here. So I will talk about this, what is this interface all about, but let's finish this tender response. I have the base template here. I am going to share with few people. It is absolutely safe and secure. You can define who can do what. I am adding few people. Shashank, Fifi, these are the guys.
So are you saying that only these people will be able to see this document?
Nobody else will be able to. And even if somebody forwards the URL, he clicks on that URL, he will anyway see a login password, so he can't make any sense. Please complete ASAP. So this goes as an email to them, and we have configured that if it goes outside my domain, have one more round of, are you sure? So email has gone. So this is nothing but a simple way of collaborating a document. Yeah, you can see some icons. These are nothing but the people who have logged in right now. Pratish has logged in, Shashank has logged in, and just observe what they are doing right now. I am not touching the keyboard. It need not be a broadband connection. In India, people use it with normal dongle, be it Reliance or Tata, that dongle or office connection as well.
So here's where you're seeing collaboration happening real time. Talk about innovation. Talk about Harshal not having to worry about which is the latest version, where can I find it, how do I access it. He could be sitting in a train and at 4:49 and wants to send it out before 5. He could send it using his mobile or his iPad. That's the power, guys. That's the power that's coming with innovation. That's the innovation that we're talking about, of moving to applications that you can use to help you, help your enterprise be more productive.
Conventionally, what people usually do is this kind of project tender comes in, and I have seen that happen. As part of transition, I ask them that how you are using it right now. They say, I have a, you know, email blocker, more than 1 MB, it cannot go. But I need to send an attachment. So he sends attachment to like 7 people. Expecting response to come back, which everyone does, right? You send attachment, and you say that you do this, you do this, you do this, by evening 5 o'clock. 4 people send response, 1 people doesn't send, you're stranded. Your whole time is wasted in just doing mundane job of checking whether he's sending, not sending, then you try to synchronize that document. Now what is happening is people are actually working. I am not bothered, people are working. If somebody is not available, that's fine. I have given him a deadline by evening 5 o'clock. I will come back at 5 o'clock and I will try to close it.
What's more important if you really see, with applications such as Google, we don't need training. Did you get trained how to use Gmail? We did not. Why so? Because these are applications, and companies like Google spend a lot of money to make sure that these applications are easy to use. Easy to use and be productive, guys. I've seen it happen, not once, in my own personal life, and I'm sure I can share it with you. My parents probably never saw an email account in their lives. But when I moved out from India, I just gave them a Chrome device, and I said, at least you can talk to me. We use GTalk in our personal lives. I do it with my parents every 3 days. This is getting closer. This is, they didn't feel that pinch so much of having the son move out as much as they felt if I was just talking on the phone. It is touching our personal lives. And now is the time that enterprises embrace the same technology to make that difference happen. That's what the messaging is all about. So, Harshal, that was an easy one, you know, but I have a very difficult person. Mm-hmm. She's Kathy from my marketing division, and she just troubles me so many number of times of having a survey done.
Okay, great.
Great? You don't know the kind of life I'm leading, buddy.
How you use it as of now, otherwise? Does it take like months?
It takes me 3 days, actually, to really help first understand what she wants. Mm-hmm. Then I get my IT team involved, which are like three developers, and we have this amazing platform, actually, where they create it in a week, and then we give it back to Kathy. But then she again comes back and asks for a change. That time is the trouble time.
Okay.
So help me, how Google Apps can really help me?
Of course, I can show you. And we use it day in, day out. You don't need IT. You don't need any training. You can create forms in minutes. Before getting into forms, I'm just going to pause for a couple of minutes to show about this specific interface where this document gets stored, right? We created a document, so I will quickly touch on this. This is nothing but the drive that we talked about, where you see my drive, people who have shared documents with me. I can make my drive offline. So if I'm not connected, I can still work. So be it mail, be these, you know, the documents. No internet, doesn't matter. I can still work. You know, if I'm in the flight, I will create my emails or compose documents. Once connection comes in, I will sync in. This specific vital sign is not using Google Drive or Google Apps. So what we can do is you can even download in whichever format you want. Same way, if I get a DocX file or a different format of file while uploading, I can say just convert in Google Docs. Every user is given 30 GB of space, which is good enough.
30 GB?
Huge.
Ooh.
And there is no need of 5 MB attachment or 1 MB attachment blockers. So that is taken care. So the specific point that you ask about is around survey forms, OK? So let me create one simple one. So the interface that you see here is make a copy, revision history. Basically, there is no limit to the revision history. It could be 1 lakh versions of it. Yeah, it's the same document. So you click here, for example. I'm just going to click somewhere else. So you will see what was the revision at that point in time. There are APIs through which you can, you know, export it out. So a lot of ways you can manage. And many projects that people do, here this tender document, after evening 5 p.m., I'm going to remove the access rights of these guys from edit to view only. So my document is done. So what happens is we have APIs. By default, this is a user interface. User interface is aimed to see what is the business change that has been done in the document. So it will show it here. Using APIs, you have the entire log. So for log keeping, if you want to keep it, there is a extract through which you will know the entire change.
Now there is a right at the bottom, you can see the changes. You can actually see what changes, they can highlight the changes. Bottom.
I clicked on something. There are three different color codes. So if you want to export, you can do it. Otherwise, visually, you can see what changes people are doing.
You can go back to your own revision. See, I told you, these guys are good guys. They know what they want.
Yep. So here, I'm going to create a simple form. You talked about a survey form. I'm going to create a very, very simple one-field form, just to show you the simplicity. You need not be a trained expert or a developer for this. You create this survey form. I will say, for the discussion's sake, I will say that I am sending it to the team members or the people who have purchased a TV for last 1 year, and simple survey, how many support calls you have opened. So let me create that, you know, simple survey, and I will also show you a complex survey that we have done. I click on form, create form. Survey for TV. Give feedback about support cases opened. How many support cases have you opened in last 1 year since purchase? Survey, I mean, these are almost all permutation combinations that anybody would need as part of the survey. So you can choose what you want, be it a grid or a date or, you know, check boxes. Once, twice, more than two, and none. I say that, you know, I have created this simple form. I say it is a required field. What you can configure as part of design is whether you want this to be an anonymous survey or whether you want the employee's LDAP or his information also to come in. So I'm going to select this. I'm going to say that a person has to log into this to view the form. Many people actually publish this form on the web pages as well. I will show it a bit later. And after the submission is done, whether I need to give a thank you message, you can define. Show link to submit another form, I don't want. So it is done. So this is done. So I'm going to send the form. Like I have shared a document, this is nothing but a document. And actually you can do it from any device, be it this device or a phone or
I would
whatever.
Love to try it from my iPad. Can you send it to me so that I can try it out?
Yeah. Subhash, I will just send it to 2-3 people for the time being.
To capture the LDAP.
Correct. I will send it to Subhash C. Subhash at my back. I send it. So it goes as an email. Now here it is saying where you want that form to be submitted. In your case, you talked about. It takes 3 days or 5 days, or I don't know that whoever the developer team, whether you need to ask them every now and then, what is the report. So here is the report. It gets stored. I say create. It creates a document. This is my survey. This is my response. I can have the survey form, complex survey form. I can have more editors as well. Add collaborator, so it is not just one. It could be multiple people who are creating this survey. Oh, I can see some response. Somebody has already started giving some response. You got it in your...
Yeah.
Can you change the display as well?
I want to use my iPad to give this feedback.
iPad, huh? Okay.
Yeah, so funky one, I bought it.
And you can see it getting updated there once you submit. Great. So what does that mean? It means that whatever you do, you get the response then and there itself. Anish, we have seen many customers have saved tons of money and huge productivity for HR. HR has their annual cycle or, you know, twice a year. They create complex surveys. They send it to outside party. It's a big cycle. 15 lakh, 20 lakh, I don't know how much money gets wasted in that. If not outside, you need to commission two servers. You know, database license itself, like 30 lakhs. Forget about anything else. So it's a huge infrastructure. Here you can do it in no time. And the responses that I talked about, you can see the summary of responses then and there itself. You
wow.
don't need any business intelligence tool. You can just see the responses what people are putting in.
This is awesome. It's important to note that Harshal did not need to go to IT, or users do not need to go to IT to help them create these. It's more than the cost, I think it's important to know that having these done, and these are important to our business. I'm sure I can argue with people who say that surveys are not important, because still we get feedback, we don't know whether what we are doing is the right thing to do. And it's so important because now users can create these surveys, do understand what the responses are from with their larger ecosystem, not necessarily like Harshal mentioned about just the internal HR, the internal employees. I can send it out. I can have anonymous surveys done. But as long as I get this feedback, and I don't need to get IT or anybody or business analyst to help me understand this, I can understand this because I'm business. That's the power. That's the power that you get with using Google Apps. Let's put another tough one to Harshal. You know, Harshal, one of the biggest things in my company is that we hire so many new people, and we need to train them. Mm-hmm. You know, we need to get them videos, and we need to make them understand what our messaging is. I can understand RedRike, and they can go search for these documents. But isn't there a way that I can just get it all in one place that I can then distribute it out to these new users?
Yep.
Or maybe some of my old ones, because, you know, they forget. They're getting old.
So are you referring to, you know, intranet, microsites, those areas? So that
sounds good. What do you have? Let me see what you have.
Yeah, definitely. I want to show you just as an example. So I'm going to show you the same thing. Google Apps for Business, even this is licensed as part of it. So let me go to sites. This runs on the same infrastructure that in the morning we talked about. It runs on Google Cloud. So whether you define one microsite or 1,000 microsites, we don't care. It's part of your domain. So I'm going to create a site. Either start with a blank document or let me browse through a category. Something public or something, say, featured. Intranet, let me try intranet. So certain templates are already available, or you can start from scratch. So let's use this site template. Give a name, intranet, various options. I will use the template and I will say create. Now what Google is doing, all those pages, microsites are getting assembled for your domain. In half a minute, the site gets created for you. Once the site gets created for you, then Anish, I'm sure the training and other bits and pieces, it could be training division, it could be IT division, it could be, you know, Corpcom or, you know, branding division. You can give access rights to respective department people. So this location will be used by another site. Okay, I have another site. Let me say Corp Intra. Create a site. So this is creating site on its own. The best practices of portal creation are taken into consideration. So you don't need to have platoon of Java developers, platoon of .NET developers doing work for you. Site gets created. You can create this site as an intranet. Many companies use their public facing websites using Google Sites. So you can configure. And you can do a lot of wonders here. For example, let me go to calendar. Now consider this to be, say, HR calendar. It's a HR department. And I want to give access to HR. I give access and I say I want to edit the page. This is the calendar entry. There are properties. Why can't I display India holidays calendar? So these calendars are already defined. You can create your calendar. You can share your calendar to be made public to your domain. So I'm sharing Indian holidays. I say select, save. I saved this. Now what has happened is base calendar gets superimposed by one more layer of the calendar that I have defined. This is Mahatma Gandhi, and let's see if 15 August. Yeah. So what I have just shown is you create site in no time. You give access rights to the site. It could be a microsite, it could be a, you know, group wide site. You can authenticate, integrate with LDAP. You don't need to wait for 2 years. You don't need to provision big rack boxes and big 16-core servers to run it. It is running on Google infrastructure. And the look and feel can be jazzy, the way you want.
Can I put up my picture there?
Yes, you can do your picture. You can have, this is some simple site where we have developed some tabs. So this training, this is one interesting case. This is in a hotel industry where they wanted to put in an intranet about how to make a bed. The use cases you can think about in your specific domain, in your specific company, it can become endless. A new company or a new employee joins in, his onboarding process could be as simple as that. It could be HR, it could be marketing guys, new product getting developed. The entire training is automated. We also provide something like a private YouTube channel. Many companies are using this, and say CEO message or annual shareholder meeting, all those videos they upload, make it available as public. So you can define what is to be published, what is not to be published. So it can really work wonders. All our Google microsites are on sites. We create it, we manage it. IT need not even bother.
One of the big things that we at Google really believe that to make innovation happen, it's about taking those baby steps. It's about not about, it's thinking big, but at the same time, take those mini steps as to how do you get there. And this technology today is really helping you because it's making things possible to do what probably took such a long time, in such a short period, to be more effective within the organization. It's not about public websites. I think, understand the value of these sites. This is more for your ecosystem when you have partners that you want to share the messaging with. Like any organization would have, partners who help them sell, where they don't have the reach. And how do you make sure that that messaging goes across to their sales team in the same way that our sales team is getting that message? This is for that particular use, not having a public website. Harshal, the other thing that I really want to know is, these are great things, and my team can help do this. Mm-hmm. But we heard Mohit talk about, this marketplace where you have these applications.
Yep.
How does one go about creating it, and where are they available, actually?
In fact, it's a website where the developers or companies develop some specific apps, which are nothing but toppings on top of Google Apps for Business. And the administrator with proper controls can enable those for the domain. This is the marketplace. You can identify which application or topping that you want. Many of them are free, many of them are paid. So you can decide which one you want. So these are some of the marketplace apps which I have loaded for my domain. And depending on what you want, you can select, you can provision specifically for you.
But how are they developed? Where does one go about learning about how to develop them?
On the google.com itself, you can start searching. You can go here, this is the website. You can go to Enterprise Marketplace or search for Google Apps Marketplace. There is a way through which you can become a vendor, as you can see the link. So many developers, it could be a big company or it could be a small company. We have a maker-checker proper process before publishing that into the marketplace. So you can, people can do that.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Harshal, for coming today and explaining to my team.